Good morning, students. Hope that all of you are safe and fine at home. May I also hope that you all enjoyed learning the lesson Rural Administration, that is the sixth chapter in your civics textbook. Today, let us try to learn the next chapter, Urban Administration. Children, what do you see in these two pictures? Do you see flats? Along with that, you can also see slums where the poor people live, and the surroundings of their houses will be filled with garbages. Have you ever thought of who is ensuring that the cities are cleaned regularly, the garbages are removed regularly? Have you ever thought of who is providing safe, clean drinking water to the people living in these cities? Let us try to find out answers to these questions by learning this lesson, Urban Administration. We know that most of the people living in villages are either farmers or fishermen. But the kind of job that people do in cities is different. And the nature of the environment is different in a city. So the way the governments follow to administer a village is different from the way the government follows to administer a city. A city, as you all know, is much bigger than a village and it is spread out. A city has crowded markets. You can see hospitals and modern means of transport in a city. Urban administration is carried out by urban local government bodies that are constituted as per the size of a town or city in India. The 74th Amendment Act of the Constitution of India mentions three kinds of urban local self-governing bodies. They are municipal corporation. There will be a population of more than 1 million in municipal corporation. The second one is municipal council, and the third one is city council. You see the office of Bhubaneswar Municipal Corporation on the left side. Some of you might have watched news related to Hyderabad Municipal Corporation election, local body government elections in the state of Kerala, which were held recently. So, let us try to learn about municipal corporations in detail. For the purpose of conducting elections, the city is divided into wards. The members of a corporation are elected by adult citizens of the city. A person who wants to contest election must be at least 21 years old. The elected members are known as councillors. The number of elected members depends upon the size of the city's population. Say, for an example, in Hyderabad, the total number of councillors will be 150, and in Thiruvananthapuram it is 100. Aldermen are the nominated members in municipal corporations. The head of the municipal corporation is known as the mayor or mahapaur. Now let us try to learn the functions of a municipal corporation. A municipal corporation maintains public hygiene. A lot of work is being done to keep the cities clean. As a part of it, garbages are cleared regularly. Local self-governments in cities take care of maintaining public health. It also keeps records of births and deaths, and thus it helps the governments to know about the population in the city. And in addition to these things, municipal corporations provide educational facilities. It builds and maintains schools at all levels, as well as maintain public libraries, orphanages, museums, colleges, etc. Municipal corporation maintains parks, street lighting, public conveniences, roads and bridges. We have understood that municipal corporation has to take care of a lot of things. Definitely, municipal corporation needs a lot of money to do these things. From what does municipal corporation get all this money? Chief sources of income for a municipal corporation are taxes and grants from the state and central governments. Corporation can collect the following taxes like octroi or terminal tax, entertainment tax, property tax, toll tax, water tax, etc. In addition to these things, corporation gets grants in aid from the state and central governments. You can read about community protests in your textbook in page number 60 and 61. Yasmin Gala gathered a small group of women to meet the ward councillor. You can read the story about her in the textbook. What do we have to understand from that story? When people stand together, local self-governments become ready to listen to what the people have to say. Hope that you all enjoyed learning and understood the lesson. Here is an assignment for you. Please try to find out answers to these questions. The first one, write a short note on the sources of income of the municipal corporation. The second one is, explain the functions of a municipal corporation. With this session has come to an end. That's all for the time being. Thanks for being with me. Take care. Stay safe.